hot and dusty evening, under a low red sun, I heard from behind me the sound of the cocking of a gun. A frozen place, and heard a voice say,
"Reach for the sky."
And he said,
"Turn around,
but go real slow." Couldn't place him, but he looked like someone I'd known. I thought about my life, and of better days to die.
He asked, "What are you transporting with that pony and cart?"
I said, "That's my business." He said,
"Don't get smart."
And he raised his big old six gun, which was about the size of my arm. "Can you even aim?" "Well, that there cannon," I said. He said,
"You'll soon enough know when you're soon enough dead."
My wits came to focus, and I sought to turn on the charm. Now this outlaw was bigger than most men you could know, but something about his talk revealed something kind of slow, and I thought quickly on how my faculties could ascertain the upper hand. I looked at his shooting iron, a fine piece of metal, and I figured out how this dullard I'd settle. I began my plan with a pointed reprimand. I told him, "You can't hit shit with a pistol that size." He looked disconsolate and a little more and half surprised. Barking, he cried,
"Why, this gun here's worth more than your soul."
"My soul ain't worth much, still a human ripped off. Shooter like that, it don't kick, it just coughs. It's a weak and a cheap metal, and it'll provide you with no control."
"It ain't weak, it's heavy strong," is what he replied.
"I'm sorry, partner, but your gunsmith has lied. I can see by the way you throw it around, that thing there ain't nothing but a toy."
He said, "Well, it's light to me, my superior size."
I said, "Well, I could test it to better criticize." He looked at me funny, and then he said,
"Okay, cowboy."
Carefully, he unloaded the chambers, one bullet at a time. Handed me the empty gun, and I could see it sure was fine. It weighed about a ton. I even struggled to lift the darn thing. I said, "Gee whiz, Hoss, you weren't half kidding. This weapon here sure could give someone quite a licking." And he smiled, and I raised that pistol up and took a swing. His face busted open with the force of the steel, and for such a big man he gave an undignified squeal as his head turned into a puddle of blood, bone, and brain. I saddled my pony, the sun was now set. I left the dead man his gun, something I now regret. And I rode through the evening thinking, smells like rain.